The Indigenous Edmonton Entertainment Group Association, in partnership with Explore Edmonton, bring you, for the first time ever, an incredible Indigenous experience at K-Days in the Edmonton Expo Center, Hall C, July 22nd through 31st, 2022, 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. 10 days of fun-filled events with a trade show, arts and crafts market, career fair, art walk, fashion show. Check out the Indigenous Tourism booth and join us for Community Day, Indigenous Day, and Pride Day. There will be guest speakers and access to information and resources relating to Treaty 101, 60th Street, MMIWG, Truth and Reconciliation. Learn about traditional medicines and healing at From Sea to Heart, Kayas Maskiki. Don't forget the live entertainment featuring Susan Aglukark, Derek Miller, Don Amaro, Kaylee Cardinal, Relic, Drives the Common Man, North Country Rock, Leanne Goose, Donita Large, Chelsea Young, Marty Wildman. See you there.
Edmonton's popular K-Days reopened its doors in summer 2022 with an important addition to the 10-day festival.
Hello, I'm Lyle Donald. I'm the president of the Indigenous Edmonton Entertainment Group. Welcome to the Indigenous Experience.
Explore Edmonton partnered with the Indigenous Edmonton Entertainment Group Association in introducing the Indigenous Experience Pavilion.
They've been amazing partners. They've helped us because we were very new. We only had about 6 or 7 months to try to pull this together. We've got a great team of people, an amazing board that has helped with all their skills. They've come back with the knowledge that we needed to be able to do this.
And as you see, we have a live stage behind us that we are doing a lot of entertainment with. And over here, we have crafters, people that do their own beading and all these different handicrafts. And they're all gifted artists, and we are proud to have them here as part of our event.
Hello, my name is Derek Starlight, and I'm about to do my Indigenous puppet show right here at K-Days on the Spotlight Stage. Let's go!
The Indigenous Experience Pavilion featured a variety of talented Indigenous artists and musicians, a trade show, a healing garden, and much, much more. Also allowed First Nations, Inuit, and Métis to share their lived experiences with non-Indigenous Canadians.
It's just such an overwhelming experience to be a part of it, and to see non-Indigenous people enjoying everything they can get out of it. It's why they call it the Indigenous Experience.
What we're trying to do is an educational component, which includes Truth and Reconciliation, Missing and Murdered Indigenous Women, the 60s Scoop.
To not only entertain people, but to bring culture and awareness on a lot of our issues that are important with missing and murdered Indigenous women, with the children being found at residential schools, with the 60s Scoop, all of it. It's a pivotal time in reconciliation for all people.
This is now on Canadians' mind, and it's a really hard topic to talk about, really hard topics, but it's also really important, and I'm just impressed that so many people, whether settler or indigenous, are coming in, they're engaging with it, they're picking up some of our information, and they're educating themselves.
We have a lot of work to do as Canadians, both indigenous and non, in the area of reconciliation. And not the work itself, because that really can't start until we have shared stories.
And I would ask them to reach out to the various people that they see that are vendors or that have display booths to learn more about the true shared history of Canada and the true shared history of this province.
Something about you that I just can't explain now, looking at you. I still feel that way. Girl, you still got it, no doubt about it. Lord knows I could never live without it. And if you ask me tomorrow by tonight, I'll tell you the same, that it wasn't the dress, no, it wasn't those shoes, wasn't the song we were listening to. It was the way you were shaking, the way you were taking my breath away with every move. Wasn't your head done up just right? The only one thing caught my eye, all of the rest I could forget. To tell you the truth, it wasn't a dress, baby, it was you.
You know, one of the things that I remember Marie Sinclair saying as with the Truth and Reconciliation Commission was, their organizations need to be more intentional about creating space for Indigenous experiences, right? And that's exactly what this is. And KDAZ has done a great job of creating this space. Now, I think if more and more organizations, like you and I were talking a little while ago, take the time to consider what does reconciliation mean? It's more than just a land acknowledgement. It's more than just saying this is where we stand, but saying this is what we recognize, but this is what the work that we're doing. And that, to me, feels like reconciliation, because reconciliation is building relationships through things like this.
So what is special about the Indigenous experience is that here we get to learn about Indigenous cultures, Indigenous history, at the same time engage in the reconciliation and the role that we all need to play to build a better future for all of us together.
So a big part of our job is to help elders pass down their teachings to the coming generations. And so we're doing that by offering calendars in conjunction with hosting elders at our booth so that they can speak to the public and educating them about their experiences.
Plants and medicines are so important to us, and the way we have used and have always used the medicines. And so the inspiration was to build a space where everybody can come and smell, touch, talk, meditate, and reflect in a space that's healing and nurturing.
So with my photography, I used these baby moccasins to represent the children affected by the Missy and Murd Indigenous women. I call it the forgotten moccasins because the children are being forgotten.
Because historically, our stories are not, they're sad stories, and we want to give good stories because we want to pave the way for a good, healthy relationship and instill that pride in our people.
You know, the purpose of Indigenous experience at KDAZ is just to unite all the people. You know, it's just like we all come together through love, through just love of music and love of like our culture, our traditions, our languages, and the revitalization of all that. Like, yo, this is like first and foremost the resistance. But at this point now, like, we're into the resurgence part of it, so we're rising.
Yeah, and also it's that togetherness and that sense of belonging, you know what I mean? Like, because not everybody grows up in, like, in their homelands or in the res. Some people grow up in the city, so like when there's gatherings like this, it gives them a sense of belonging, and like it helps them reconnect, or it helps them just vibe, you know what I mean? Like, it's beautiful to see.
Yo.
The fire's blazing, the kick is tapped, and where we're at ain't on the map. It is what it is, a small town.
Everything is special about our culture, so we get to showcase it here at KDAZ, and it's a very special event, and one of those things that are kind of near and dear to my heart is I've always wanted to play music here, so I finally got the chance to do that.
We're still here. You know, we're resilient. We're talented. We're smart. We have a different system and way of being that it doesn't come from the systems of money, right? It's built on tradition and culture. It's built on those foundations of our laws.
So my name is Sabrina Williams, and this is my daughter, Shelby Williams. We are with the I Am Collective, and we are all artisans, part of an 80-plus artisan group, which is the I Am Collective. So we sell anything from ribbon skirts to ribbon shirts, from jams to bannock to earrings to bracelets. Anything you need, we have.
We're the local indigenous-owned hot sauce and spice company. We make healthy, delicious, and amazing products. Sodium-free, gluten-free, vegan, flavor-first all around, and we just want to have an amazing product that people enjoy.
Denny Divas is a family-run company between me, my mom, and my other sister, and we create candles and smudge-filled products in order to modernize smudge for everyone to enjoy and use.
It's been great. It's been nice to be here and come out and see and meet different people and be able to display what I can do and represent my artwork and myself. And I work in Plains Indian Designs, and so that's for me, it's an honor to be able to bring that to people and have them experience that along with all the other music and all that great stuff that's going on here.
My work, what I do with my work is I try and represent pride. So I'm trying to give my people back their pride through visionary artwork, and our pride was taken away through the residential school. So I'm just here to empower my people with my work. It's been amazing to be here and see all the talent and the performers, the talented performers, and it's a really good turnout this year. A lot of good energy here.
Empowering the community, and that's what's very important nowadays, because that's what we need. We need to empower each other.
The purpose of this event was just to bring everybody out. You know, it's the first time K-Days has been back since COVID happened. And seeing everybody out, seeing everybody smile, everybody dance, everybody screaming and shouting, and the vendors, people coming out with shirts, so excited from the music. That's what it's all about. It's about laughter, it's about lifting up the spirits.
My name is Derek Miller, Six Nations of the Grand River, Southern Ontario, and I'm here to play music at K-Days with my band, the Los Lindos. Well, I think it's amazing to have anything that's celebrating indigeneity and different indigenous cultures. It's very cool to be diverse and explore each other's cultures and learn from each other to become better people.
Well, it brings people in to learn, to educate, but also to give them an experience of healing, what can occur when you're on your healing journey.
For the visionaries, the introduction of this Indigenous Experience Pavilion was an opportunity that paid off.
That with all of us working together, we've been able to put on an event that's been extremely successful and has showcased Indigenous people in this country so that all the people that came into K-Days were able to see the impact and effect that Indigenous people have from a very healthy way.
It's great to have an event that shows our Indigenous community as good, successful people and people that that are contributing to the economy here and also to our city, our country. And
having this, the Indigenous experience here as a partnership with Explore Edmonton is a wonderful thing for our people, but also It's a great learning for the non-Indigenous people to come and share the experience of what we have to offer as craftspeople, as entertainers, sharing our culture through all of that and with the food and everything that Indigenous people do and the stories that we are willing to share. And we have the teepee set up to show that this is the place to come and share the Indigenous experience, and we're looking forward to having this happen in the future and invite all people to come and be a part of it to support what we're doing.
But hopefully this time around, after a 10-day experience here, that you know, getting to know the not only the history documented there, but talking to the staff, that they will get to know more about it, and then, okay, I understand, right? I understand where they're coming from.
The quality that we've got this year, and the just the impressiveness of the variety of entertainment, I think will just set this up and for greater success next year. So that's what I'm more excited about.
So I'm recognized as an artist in Alberta. Because of my accomplishments in hoop dancing, I've acquired some world championship titles in my career, and I'm a three-time world champion hoop dancer. I've been dancing for 30 years, so I've been doing it a long time. I've done 6 albums. The music in the background that's playing here is actually my music. It's part of the ambiance here, and besides that, I'm here on stage. Like usually when I do my shows, I'm kind of a storyteller and an educator, and my show is more than just entertainment. It's really engaging for the audience, for me to share the stories of who we are, you know, like. Not only the historical perspective, but we're also, I get to share my own personal story on stage, and I think that's what resonates good with audiences. So that's what kind of artist I am. I just come from a real perspective and an organic, authentic place. We unintentionally became the largest festival in Canada, and it's all Indigenous, and it's, I think that's something that speaks volumes and something to be proud of, for sure.
The Indigenous Edmonton Entertainment Group Association, in partnership with Explore Edmonton, bring you, for the first time ever, an incredible Indigenous experience at K-Days in the Edmonton Expo Center, Hall C, July 22nd to 31st, 2022, 12 p.m. to 10 p.m., featuring Susan Aglicarth, Derek Miller, country music artist Chucky Beaver, Rudy Strangling Wolf and Marty Wildman, North Country Rock, Chelsea Young, Light Rose, hip-hop artist Joey Styles, Relic. Rock to drives the common man in his nostalgic blend of alternative pop. Singer-songwriters Stephanie Harp, Donita Large, Kaylee Cardinal, Donna Mero, Jared Putra, Leanne Goose join the celebration with traditional artists such as Fawnwood, Dene the Drummers, Rock and Fiddle, Brianna Lazotte. Enjoy the talents of puppeteer Derek Starlight, the power of hoop dancers Dallas Arcan and Eric Pipestem, co-hosted by local news anchor Daintree Christensen and former Commissioner of the Northwest Territories, George Tuckerow. For times and dates, please check out the attractions and activities schedules at k-days.com. See you there.